So while the ducks are in the potty getting that prepared, I've done some modifications to their pond. So the first thing I did was give it a stone surround so they're not eroding the edge all the time. Still needs a little bit more around this edge, but it's pretty much finished. And when the pond's up to its normal height, it's a bit low at the minute, it's just below the level of those flat stones. But the biggest change to the pond is I fitted this second Monk. Works exactly the same as the one that feeds into the paddy field, only this one's set about 2 inches higher, again with a swivel, and that comes through and out here into a wetland filter. You see, just sticking out the water there, there's a few plants just sticking out. That's typha, that's greater reed mace, which is one of the biggest biomass generating crops that you can grow. This is a tiny little version of it. I mean, it's a fair size to dig out by hand, but time's something we've all got on our hands now, isn't it? So that goes down about 2 foot lower than the waterline. I've backfilled it with a little bit of topsoil and a bit of manure and planted it up with typha. So that'll fill very quickly in, so that water coming from the paddy or direct from the pond, the duck pond, will come through here and we'll get to extract another crop out of it before it goes on its way down the swale. So all I want to do is, if I want to harvest something out of the paddy fields, I want that to dry out. All I do is twist this swivel pipe so that it's marginally lower than that pipe, and as water runs in here, it'll run out of this rather than that. But I can also use it just for discharging this pond completely, which I'm not going to do now, but that's back upright again. So yeah, I can do that to completely empty it, to harvest the sludge at the bottom of it, which, yeah, that's a different video, but that's a pretty cool thing. So yeah, it's designed so that I can just drop the water out of it fairly easily. It takes about 15 minutes to do, and then I can salvage all the mud out the bottom of it, because in the center there you can see it looks fairly shallow, but that's quite that dark black mud that just builds up in the bottom of the duck ponds. The actual clay layer is about a meter below that, so there's a lot of it in there. You know, we're not going to run out anytime soon. So that comes out into there, but I can also, of course, do the same thing I always could with that swivel pipe there, and I can drop the water out of the paddy, and that goes now through the filter as well. So again, all that lovely manky duck water, once it's been populated, at the moment it's just got going, but by the end of this year this should be pretty full with them. And also, because obviously I'm generating a lot of material, I've reinforced the berm on that side of the duck pond. So now, I mean, it looks rough, it hasn't been compacted, doesn't really matter for this sort of feature. The ducks will come through and within a fortnight they'll have that compacted to this stuff here. And even in winter, that's like concrete. It's amazing what ducks do to ponds. So all this will be rock solid. So in the event that got blocked, because at the moment it's just a little bit of runoff from all around it that's going in here, and I top it off occasionally with water from the hose pipe, but eventually most of the structures we've got around the rainwater will be fed through here. So even though it's a fairly small duck pond, it'll have a lot of water running through it, so I can have that clearing the duck pond and feeding the typha and then the swale and on down the system, or I can have it go through the paddy and take that crop from it. But it gives me a lot more choices. But also, I mean, you get an amazing amount of flow through a pipe that big. But in the event of a major, major rain event, and that wasn't coping, after the pond water's come up a couple of inches, that one kicks in and that takes it as well. And if something major catastrophic happened and something blocked one of them and it wasn't able to cope and it came up completely, this here, once it's been compacted a bit more by the ducks, is completely level and the water will sheet off there and into the filter. So, you know, it shouldn't cause any erosion or cause any problems. I've dumped that entire pond, as I say, in about 10 minutes down that swale, and there was no erosion. It coped with it easily. So I've tested that So a couple of days off, stuck at home. What are you going to do? Dig a major earthwork.